Let's go in deep. There is the fuse box. Yeah, don't go randomly pulling fuses.
Had a little bit of an issue last weekend where apparently I blew a fuse on my Model X. Now, I did an upgrade. I replaced the X's black and white Autopilot 2.0 camera, the triple forward facing camera. I replaced it with the later generation colored, I should say partially colored, camera, whereas the first one had a habit of seeing red and black and white for the most part. The newer one sees all the colors, just not full color. Don't know if I'm explaining that right. Probably not. Either way, when I did that, I had to remove the rearview mirror. And I noticed that the little plug-in for the self-dimming rearview mirror wasn't the best, but it seemed to clip in. Well, apparently not, because now a year or so later, what I think happened was that clip was just making intermittent connection, must have had a little bit of sparking or something, and it blew the 5-amp fuse. Unfortunately, that fuse also controlled not only the dimming mirror, but the lighted cabin mirrors and tire pressure monitoring system. Great. So let's replace the fuse. Well, any of you seasoned Tesla owners already know, Tesla doesn't like giving up the information. There is no diagram publicly available which fuse does what. They just want you to make a service appointment and pay $150 an hour, sometimes more, for them to replace the fuse for you. Don't I vaguely remember Elon stating they don't want to make money, they don't want service to be a profit center or something like that. Either way, what would have taken me 2 minutes, if even that long, if I had a fuse diagram, took me a week of trying to figure out which fuse it was. Because, you know, unlike my friend Bjorn, hi Bjorn, who had some issues randomly pulling fuses on his Model X to try and find the one that blew, I think it was for his trailer lights, I wasn't going to go that route. I did end up figuring it out. It was, well, whatever fuse number I write in the description box of the video below, because I don't remember off the top of my head. But it was an in-cabin fuse, and it was a 5-amp. Now, of course, being Tesla, Tesla doesn't do anything normal, not even the simple stuff. So instead of using a standard 2-blade fuse, now this is a mini fuse. Now there's also one that's half that size, a micro, and this isn't a micro, but that's what a micro fuse size fuse is. No, they couldn't have used that. Well, Tesla does use some micro fuses, but for some reason, they decided to use a triple blade micro fuse. Yeah. You know where you can find these? Not at your auto parts store. Napa didn't have them. AutoZone didn't have them. Advanced Auto didn't have them. O'Reilly's didn't have them. Farm and Fleet did not have them. Walmart even didn't have them. I could not find them at any local store. So I did a little hack job with a mini fuse just temporarily to make it work. So at least I had TPMS, made all the errors on my screen go away. Half the fuse does TPMS, self-dimming mirror, and your lighted mirrors. The other half of the fuse does ABS, traction control, stability control, and I think I got like 50 other errors, which at least that worked until I pulled the fuse out. So I'm going to show you where that fuse goes. Now, some people power, dash cams off of the power for the mirror, the lighted mirror, or the dimming mirror. So you're going to want to know this too. So let's go take a look and I'll show you exactly where you go for that fuse. And yes, if you look real closely, there is a way to test these fuses without having to remove them. And that's kind of how I eventually found it, is you can stick a multimeter probes in there and check for continuity. So, I only had minis on hand to show you guys. Let's go take a look. Let's go fuse hunting. So we're going to go down here. First thing we are going to do, we are going to pull this size side here, because I actually have the bad fuse back in, so I can demonstrate and pull it. Now loosen this up here. Pop goes the weasel. Next, we got to remove this section. Let's see if I can prop the phone up here. Hopefully it doesn't overheat. We're gonna pull this carpeted section off somehow. We're gonna do this without disassembling a good chunk of vehicle. I have no idea where the hell that goes. Oh well. Panel off. Grab my fusey woozy. Let's go in deep. There is the fuse box. Yeah, don't go randomly pulling fuses. Let's turn on light. Won't let me. Alright. Get light. Let me get my flashlight. Woo! There we go. That did not help whatsoever. Where did that fuse go? Hold on. Lost my fuse. Zoom in a wee bit. Okay, you can see some larger fuses. And you can see some minis. Minis, mini, 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 mini. And see those larger blue ones? And then that red one down there? Those are triple blade fuses. So, small one on the left, that's a micro fuse. Was I saying minis? No, I meant micro. So those small ones on the left, those are micro fuses. Those one on the right are triple blade micro fuses. In all my years in automotive, I have never seen a triple blade micro fuse. I'm sorry. I know that it must have been out there for a while, especially since I was able to get them on Amazon, which the link for that will be in the description box below. They were cheap enough where you're probably going to want some on hand just to keep in a junk drawer at home just in case. And the fuse of the day is, come on, zoom, that 5 amp on the left, that triple blade on the left. So let's back out, get the fuse remover. Gonna get some error warnings. Beep. Oh god, I hope I pulled the right one. Get off of the air. Yep. You can see it's a wee bit melted. Messages today. Huh. Let's make sure they shipped me or I ordered the right thing. It's a little smaller, but everything lines up. So we'll put that bugger back in. Sorry about that. Phone overheated. I don't know why iPhones overheat so much. My 6S never overheated. I could record for an hour straight. Video recording with my 8 overheats. Video recording with my XS overheats. Video recording with my wife's 12 overheats. My 4S, 5S, 6S never overheat. So let's put that back in there. gonna have to move the camera.
There it is. Seems shorter than the originals, but it works. There we go. My phone's gonna overheat again. Put this bugger back. Shazam! Oh yeah. There you go. These are cheap too. You can get a pack of 32 assorted amperages. It's only like $13 shipped. No. Don't want to close the door. Let's see. Restore. There we go. 209 miles on the X. That's pretty sad. Got a brick of cells in my battery that is about 65 millivolts lower than the rest of the pack. Causes a whole bunch of BMS calculation issues. But of course, that's within normal specs. I'm sorry, Tesla. You guys are really dropping the ball. Anyways, adios. See you guys next video. Whee! Oh, right. Yeah, we're good. Let's see the fuses here. So, see the lit. Oh, nope. There. Blades are the same length. Overall, shorter, though. But, hey, it works. It works. Right, folks? I'll probably just put those in here with the matching different amperage sizes. Because you got 5... 7.5, 10, 15. Bye-bye.